Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for the awesome John Grant.
I just want to start off by thanking you all for being here this afternoon. I think this is a great idea, too. It's been something that I've wanted to do for a very long time, and it's a huge honor for me to work with these amazing people, and we've had a couple of great days together, so I hope you all enjoy it, and it's just a huge honor to be able to do this for you. So thank you for coming.
About it, I am successful as it were. I get to sing for lovely people all over this lovely world. And I am nowhere near as awkward as I was when I was younger. I guess I'm one of those guys who gets better looking as they age. And even though I have felt beaten down by constant doubt, depression and confusion brought about by people's actions, death and tax forms, I keep getting up. And I am loved by all my friends and family, though there have been lots of raised eyebrows and concerned glances lately. Doesn't matter to him, I could be anything, but I could never win his heart again. Doesn't matter to him, he took away my AAA pass, I am invisible to him. Flesh of my heart hardening to the countless possibilities contained within each day. Vulnerability feels like a cold, wet concrete room lit with fluorescent sunlight, which, as you know, makes everything look bad. I still keep trying to figure out how I myself, you big
Thank you. Thank you.
To say that I'm a man undone is understatement at its worst. I was completely incapacitated by your southern charm. It hit me like an ancient gypsy curse. But this instrument you use with such precision, it's like a concrete wall 1,000 meters tall. And I've tried to climb its icy walls 1,000,000 times, but I simply cannot find inside of me the requisite resolve. Your silence is a weapon, it's like a nuclear bomb. It's like the Agent Orange they use to use in Vietnam. And it's accompanied by an apathy that's deafening to the ears. You know it is complete and perfect, and you wield it without fear.
Thank you.
Thank you. This is one of my favorites to do. I actually got to take Peter to Mars. We had to drive from Toronto down to Chicago, and so that goes right through Buchanan, where I grew up, and we went into Mars. Even though they've taken the sign down now, they still have a little shrine set up in the sweet shop of, you know, the old menu. And so all the lyrics that you hear are from that menu that they have encased in glass there. It was pretty cool. And they still serve the Green River there as well. So that was pretty awesome, wasn't it, Peter? Yeah. So we're going to do that one for you now, Mars.
Sweet strawberry marshmallow butterscotch, polar bear cashew, Dixieland phosphate chocolate, lime tutti frutti special raspberry, leave it to me. Three gray scotch and lassie cherry smash and lemon free. I want to go to Mars, where green rivers flow, and your sweet 16 is waiting for you after the show. I want to go to Mars, you'll meet the gold dust twins tonight, you'll get your heart's desire, I will meet you under the light. I will need you.
Thank you. This is another favorite of mine. And when we went back to Michigan recently, I got to show Fiona, my manager, was there too, and we got to go to all these places that I talk about in this song. It's called Fireflies. And I took them back to the cemetery where there's this grave that I talk about in the song that has the pictures of two people on it, where you lift up these little, they look like large metal, silver metal brooches or lockets on the graves, set in the graves, and you open them up and there's the pictures of the people in there. And I think it's from 1836 that they died. And I used to go back there and look at that, and it was so cool to go back there and see my grandmother's grave from the little pink house with blue polka dots and show everybody the house and that picture. And well, I was a little bit alarmed at how much the cemetery has grown, but I guess that's that's the way it goes, right? The dimensions have changed, so I had trouble finding things. But yeah, we're going to do that one for you now. It's called Fireflies.
unstoppable, your confidence unspeakable. I know that I know that you know. I'm willing to do anything to get attention from you, dear. Even though I don't have anything that I can bargain with. This is like a well-oiled machine. Could I please see that smile again? All that makes me feel that I am living in this world. I see you closing all the doors. I see the walls as they go up. I know it's what you have to do. I probably do the same thing to my.
Baby, you were dreaming.
you. This is the lovely lady who arranged all of these songs for the orchestra. Miss Fiona Bryce. We're going to play one called Caramel for you now. Thank you very much. I usually introduce this one by saying that, quite simply, it's a song about how the United States is not a theocracy, which seems to be a confusing subject these days, which is confusing to me. So I thought I'd better write a song about it. It's called Glacier.
Best way you know how, but they keep on telling. were not allowed. They say you are sick, that you should hang your head in shame. They are pointing fingers and want you to take the blame. There are days when people are so nasty and convincing. They say things beyond belief that sting and leave you wincing. And to boot, they say their words come straight down from above. And they really seem to think that what they're doing counts as love. But this pain, it is a glacier moving through you. You're carving out deep valleys and creating spectacular space, nourishing the ground with precious minerals and other stuff. So don't you become paralyzed with fear. Things seem particularly rough. As they say, no, never mind. They don't give two shits about you. It's the blind leading the blind. What they want is commonly referred to as theocracy. And what that boils down to is referred to as hypocrisy. Don't listen to any. Answers on your own, even if it means that sometimes you feel quite alone. No one on this planet can tell you what to believe. People like to talk a lot, they like to deceive. This pain, particularly rough. Oh, this pain, it is a glacier moving through you, carving out the valleys and creating. flesh in the ground with precious memories and leather staff. So don't you become paralyzed with fear. Didn't seem particularly rough. Thank you. I will give him all that his heart can take, and I'll trust him fearlessly. I want him to be afraid.
Thank you. Thank you. Now I get to do some swearing, a little more swearing. I get to start to break out in a rash if I don't swear every 30 minutes or so, at least. This one's called GMF.
You could probably say I'm difficult. I probably talk too much. Yes, it's a nasty crutch. I'm usually only waiting for you to stop talking so that I can. Concerning two-way streets, I have to say
thank you.
laughing 6 to 3% more of the time. You could be laughing 25% more of the time.
Thank you.
Myself driving on the road at night, and the radio is broadcasting the ocean. Warm late spring wind whips through my hair. I am right here, but I wanna be there. And no one in this world is gonna stop me. Here being ghosts at the end of May, soldiers on this black highway, helping me to know my place. Gringos must take great care, release themselves into the air, reminding me that I must be aware.
Thank you.
must take great care, release themselves into the air, reminding me that I must be aware.
Say that is one of my favorite pieces of music of all time, that Rachmaninoff prelude in C sharp minor. Oof. I think my entire personality was determined by that song.
Remember how we used to fuck on the do I, because I always passed out. I needed lots of the booze to handle the pain. You don't have to pretend to care. You don't have to say things that you don't mean. Have to pretend to care. You don't have to say things that you don't mean. It just embarrasses me and makes you look like a fool. Stopped, and the kindness turned to pity and disgust, and the smiles were stopped before they could start. And understanding was now just a tool. We used it every chance we got to be cruel. And we cringe because we couldn't make ourselves stop. You don't have to pretend to care. You don't have to say things that you don't. You don't have to pretend to care. You don't have to say things that you don't mean. It just embarrasses me and makes you look like a fool.
Thank you.
Stuff anyway. I hope I didn't destroy your celebration or your bat mitzvah birthday party or your Christmas. You put me in this cage and threw away the key. It Was this us and them shit that did me in? You tell me that my life is based upon a lie. I casually mentioned that I pissed in your coffee. I hope you know that all I want from you is sex. To be with someone who looks smashing in athletic wear. And if your haircut isn't right, you'll be dismissed. You'll get your walking papers and you can leave now. I don't know what to want from this world. I really don't know what to want from this world. I don't know what it is you want to want from me. Why don't you take out on somebody else? Why don't you burn the shit out of somebody else? Why don't you turn somebody else in their circle? Weakly, coward, or pathetic for love. Who's gonna be the one to save me from myself? You better bring your stun gun and perhaps a crowbar. You better pack a lunch and get up really early. And you should probably get down on your knees and pray. It's been fun to look embarrassed all the time. Like you could never cut the mustard with the big boys. I really don't know who the fuck you think you are. But I please see your license and your registration. I don't know what to want from this world. I really don't know what to want from this world. Don't know what it is you want to want from me. Really have no rights, want anything from me at all. Why don't you take it out on somebody else? Why don't you pour the shit out of somebody else? Why don't you turn somebody else in their circle? Weak and coward and pathetic for sitting right here 10 years from now. You're just a sucker, but we'll see who gets the last laugh. Who knows, maybe you'll get to be the next queen of
John Grant. Can they hear that?